With coronavirus cases still high across the country, students, teachers, and parents have been forced to adapt to distance learning. Some students continue at-home instruction, while others, like many here in New York City, are returning to classrooms. Here to discuss education in the pandemic and its effect on students and the future of learning is Holly Kuzmich, Executive Director of the George W. Bush Institute. Thanks so much for being with us today, Holly. And I know you're a veteran of the Department of Education. You've said you're interested in what we're going to learn from these different ways students have been taught during this pandemic. How do you think this is going to affect education generally going forward?
Just the fact that we're using digital learning more, I think, will open people's eyes to the possibility of how to do more blended instruction in the future in schools. Even when we get kids back into school, how do you use digital tools going forward to do both in-person and online instruction? I also think schools are having to rethink their schedules overall. One of the things we've really learned about this is that school is not only a place for kids to go to learn the basics of reading and math and history and science, but it's also childcare for so many families, especially working families across this country. And that's a real challenge that families are facing. And schools and parents are having to think differently about schedules and how they even organize the school day. And so I think that realization will help open our eyes to some possibilities that we could rethink in terms of how we use time and digital tools in our schools to better serve students and families.
Yeah, we are learning a lot right now. I know an Associated Press and Chalkbeat survey found that Hispanic and Black students are more likely than white students to start the school online, but therein lies a huge concern about this digital divide and the long-term consequences of increasing that socioeconomic gap in student achievement. It is real, and it's really being understood now. What have we learned?
Well, we've already seen some preliminary studies this summer that show that low-income kids, as we had suspected, are likely falling farther behind, and we're going to have to do more work to close the gap. We also have recently seen some studies that show that high-income kids are actually doing even better than expected. So we really have this widening gap. It means that schools and teachers really have to be smart about understanding where kids are when they start the school year. Parents have to do as much as they can to be in touch with teachers, understand where their students are, what they can be doing at home to support their students and supplement instruction. But we also know this is gonna be a multi-year process to get kids back up where they need to be. We're not gonna be able to solve this in just a few weeks.
Yeah, no, that's so true. So any tips you can give parents who have their children, their students who are attending school remotely, they're doing that they're in home learning, not the in-person learning. What can you tell parents?
Well, I think really I think one of the benefits we've seen is that this is open communication between teachers and parents in a new way. And so parents should be in touch with teachers, tell them what they're seeing at home. How are their kids doing? What are they struggling with? Likewise, ask the teachers, what can I be doing to supplement and support my kids at home? And how can I be helpful to you? And really sort of do more to communicate with teachers and the principal to understand how we can get through these next few weeks and months.
Yeah, that communication more key now than ever before. Holly, thank you very much. Very important advice for parents out there. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Amy.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.